After hit, the rock group ABBA has been called Sweden's most profitable export. In fact, the foursome went public in Stockholm, where they're now traded on the stock market there. But ABBA is diversifying these days, with various members going on for solo success. Agnetha Fältskog is here with us this morning on Nightwatch to tell us about her single-minded effort. Glad to have you here.
It's nice to be here.
Welcome back to the States.
Thank you.
For a short time. Whenever individual members of groups start doing solo albums, everybody always says, is the group breaking up? Is ABBA breaking up?
I'm used to that question. And let me say that for the moment, the group has a break, because we have been working together for 14 years. And for the moment, it feels very good to do individual things. The boys are writing on a musical together with Tim Rice. And Frida's working for herself, and myself is working for myself on a solo album. And it feels good to change.
Now, does that mean that you're not going to go back together and do some things together because you're feeling so good doing your individual things?
It doesn't mean that, but we have said that we're going to have a break, and we don't know at this point.
The two women were married to the two men in the group, and everybody thought that was security for their investment. Mm. And then the two couples divorced.
Yeah,
the group didn't break up, though.
No, we've been working together for many years after that, and I must say it feels better to work after the divorce.
Why is that?
I can't explain why, but it's different anyway. But when you're away from each other, you just have the work together. It's much easier.
You don't have to talk about the kids or getting the teeth fixed or who takes out the garbage. You just deal with music.
Of course we have to, because we share the children, my husband and myself. So when we have discussed that, we're away from each other. That's good.
So how is it better? Why is it better? A lot of people don't think it's possible to work with an ex.
No, I know that, but I don't know if we are very special in Sweden, but I think it's much easier to work together with my ex-husband now.
Huh. Mm. Interesting. Mm. What does he think about your solo effort?
I haven't asked him. He told me he liked my new album very much.
You have a whole new look. You have new hair. The sound of ABBA is a little more conservative, kind of poppy. People kind of called it kind of cutesy, kind of Beatles, kind of middle of the road. Mm. It seems that your new sound and your new look is a little wilder, a little more zany.
Is it?
It seems. Is it?
I hope so.
Let's take a look at your video and see if you're still kind of middle of the road now with your new direction.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's not mom and pop stuff. Well, actually, it is mom and pop stuff, I guess. That's a little different. That's a little more sensuous. I don't think ABBA's been doing a lot of that kind of thing.
No, it's a little different. We have had a very, family style. And it's good to get away from that a bit and also show another profile for yourself.
Now, why the new direction for you?
I think as a woman, it's good to change now and then, because you get very tired of yourself. And you try to do it in a good way, that's at the same time suitable for yourself. And I think we tried this new style because we thought it would be suitable for the album.
Well, thanks for stopping by to visit. We appreciate it. Agnetha
Fältskog.
You must think you're the only one who...
Records around the globe, 200 million of them. Agneta Faltskog has recently recorded her first solo album entitled Wrap Your Arms Around Me, and before I talk with her, here's a clip of her hit single, Can't Shake Loose. Welcome to Live at Five.
Thank you.
How do you like doing the videos?
I like doing videos, and I like recording.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like that much to travel, but I have to do it sometimes.
Well, we're grateful you came by today.
Yeah, yeah, it's great to be here.
I read you were a telephone operator before fame hit. Is that correct?
I started with that.
One day you got one busy call too many or one rude customer, and you said, I'm going to be a rock star? What was it?
That was when I ended school.
Uh-huh.
I started to work as a telephone operator in a car firm.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, I worked with a dance band. So that's how I started. That was a long time ago.
How did you eventually end up with ABBA?
Oh, that started... we were solo singers, both Frida and I. And Frida met Benny. And I met Björn nearly at the same time, and they were also very well known in Sweden. So it started very naturally, so to say.
As well known as you were in Sweden, did you have any idea you were going to become as enormously successful as you ultimately became?
I think I had a feeling of that when we won the Eurovision Song Contest in Brighton in 74. I had a feeling that we have really something more to give than this Eurovision song.
Yeah. Well, when you talk about 200 million records being sold, and you talk about an income for the group, yeah, an income that I think in 1979 topped $10 million a year, and I also read that the group is the biggest industry in Sweden, eclipsing Volvo, eclipsing Saab. How do you function as a major industry in Sweden, which is a socialist country with lots of taxes?
I don't like to talk about that very much because I'm not that involved. I have to be there at those meetings.
Mm-hmm.
I know where my money is invested, are invested. But that's my kind of job. That's something we have to do because we have a very high tax.
What is the tax rate?
Situation in Sweden.
What is the personal tax rate over there?
87%.
87% of what you make goes to the government, and you get to keep a generous 13%.
Yeah. So we have to invest our money in different things.
There have been performers, people who have made a lot of money in Sweden, who have been tempted to leave and have left, in fact, because of the high tax rate. Have you ever been tempted to set up shop elsewhere in the world to avoid those very high taxes?
Of course, you think about that now and then, but we have invested our money very clever, and we are surrounded with people that we rely on and that can invest our money in a very good way. But I have no plans right now to leave Sweden, but Frida has left Sweden now for London.
Have we seen the end of ABBA with you guys going your separate ways here and you cutting a single album?
At this point, we don't know. We just have said that ABBA is going to have a break because we have been working together for 14 years. And it's good after that to try something new. So
has it been difficult those 14 years? More difficult than fun or more fun than difficult?
Both. It's good and bad. And it's good to be in a group because you rely on each other. But there also has been some bad times.
Well, we thank you very much for sharing these times with us today. It was great fun listening to your album and having a chance to chat with you today.
Nice
good
to
luck
hear.
With a single.
Thank you.
Jim.